Good morning from Camp Margaritaville here in Auburndale, Florida. Getting ready to hit the road today, and there's quite a bit of things we need to update you guys on. We last left you off at the Tampa show. I can explain. It's been extremely busy the last few days. Nene's still sleeping, and I am trying to get everything prepared before we hit the road. Today, we're not going to pull a Hanks. We normally pull a Hanks, and we are last out the door. I'm feeling good vibes. I'm out of bed, taking a morning stroll. Tanks are being dumped. I'm letting her rip. Tire pressures are checked. I think today we're gonna actually pull it off and get out on time for once. I am kind of dragging though, nonetheless. And I don't know about you guys, is this relatable? But it seems like no matter how long you've been doing this RV lifestyle, travel days are just always stressful, annoying. I don't know. There's always so many checklists to follow. We've been doing this for 5 years full time, and I don't know, it's just travel days. Tire pressures, dumping tanks, taking wide turns, taking it slow. Did we find a spot to stay? The fun just don't stop. I'm not complaining. I'm just saying. Relatable. Relatable.
Again,
can't wait to get back on the road again.
No, really, we are so excited to be back on the road. This literally can be counted as the start of our journey up to Alaska. New things are on the horizon for the Hanks family, and y'all are here with us. Yes, that's right, strap in. It's gonna be a wild ride. Another exciting snippet I wanna share with y'all is we got a new TPMS. Finally, we do not have to deal with all the beeping and nonsense that the previous one was giving us. But hold on, before you go wanting to buy this, let the Hanks give it a trial run first. I wanna make sure we're giving you a good quality product. It's very new. We literally are trying it for the first time today. And so far, so good. I'll keep you posted, however, because I wanna make sure that when you actually do go buy it, you're gonna be a happy camper with it. Going to a state park, I'm loving this. You know, the resorts are really nice, but me personally, I get, I don't know, a little burnout with it. It's too many amenities. I like to be off-grid a little more and be more in touch and at one with wilderness. And the state parks offer just that. Does that make sense to y'all? Life is all about balance, especially RV life. Everything in moderation. Don't go staying at one spot for too long. You kind of get a little burnout on it. And at the same time, don't go bouncing around too quickly, because that is a fine balance as well. Trust us when we say moving around every single day, that gets really old really fast. I'm not sure yet how I feel about this whole caravan out west. There's a lot of dynamics gonna be taking place. Traveling with more than two people, let alone six, everyone's gonna have different schedules. When do we pull over to pee? When do we gotta eat? Gotta fuel up the trucks? It's gonna throw a whole new dynamic on things. And I'm pretty excited to share it with y'all. Have you guys done the caravan thing before? If you have, throw it in the comments and give us some reassurance. And you know, as always, be real with the Hanks. If you don't want to give us reassurance and say don't do that, share that as well, because we're all about it. But guess what? We're still doing it. We landed a spot here, I think in the surrounding area of Orlando for tonight. Well, actually a few nights. And there is a couple things I wanted to touch on, but I'm gonna wait till we get there to make sure that I can like bring it in a well-presented manner to you guys. It's gonna be a little bit on the unfamiliar side for a lot of travelers out there. We'll be talking about making no reservations and maybe bringing you some reassurance in this current day and age that you don't have to stress as much as you think you do about making reservations. I'll explain more later. We're definitely pulling a Hanks today on the opposite end. Usually we're late checking out, but this time we're really early checking in. It's 12 o'clock, right on the dot, and we're pulling in a state park. Usually state parks check-in is around 3 o'clock. I think we're pushing the bar here a little bit, you know what I mean? But hey, you never know until you try. What's the worst they're gonna say? No?
Yeah, that is.
Maybe they'll have some extra parking here for us in case they're like, no, you can't check in yet.
Fingers crossed.
Come on, guys. Fingers crossed, right? See you in the back there. Yeah, let's work on... Yeah, okay, that's good.
Do I pull to the right?
I'll just pull right here. This is good.
Oh, wrong window. Hi there.
Hi, I'm on the ball for you.
Well, thank you.
I'm assuming you have a reservation?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You do know that check out time is at 1 and check in is at 3.
Yeah.
So I may not be ready for you yet.
Okay.
No problem.
We only had an hour drive, so we didn't know where to go.
What's your last name?
Thanks.
Let me check.
Thank you so much. How are you feeling about this one? Give me the inside deets here.
I mean, we can't pull in. We just chill in the truck.
Chill in the truck. That's the way the Hanks roll. We gotta have some extra parking here somewhere.
It is. Check-in is 3. And yeah, I think they have parking here. But yeah, check-in is 3 and check-out is 1 for Florida state parks. Probably a lot of state parks all over the country are like that too.
Which is nice when you're leaving.
Hanks. Okay.
So she said she doesn't, they don't see us?
Yeah, hopefully.
Well, we've been using that new app. I wonder if that didn't work out so well. It's a new app. All right, we're trying it out. We're gonna see if this actually works before we tell you guys more about it. It might not work, so hence why the Hanks are not presenting these crucial details to our peeps.
I don't see anything under H-A-N-K-S. What is your confirmation number?
Go 77.
Okay.
Thank you. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna get through this together. Our home's behind us, remember? That's the exciting part about RV life. You can go wherever you want. Doesn't work out, just move right ahead. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. Stinky Butt's okay with us. See, he has no idea what's going on ever. If you're new here, we have a cat. His name's Dexter, AKA Sexy Dexy. We have this inside joke. We never know if he truly knows that we live on a home on wheels, basically. Spoiled rotten, if you ask me. Oh, she's grabbing a bunch of papers. That's exciting.
For some reason, it shows up as an agent third party.
Agent third party.
So we booked it through an app called RV, where it like auto books for us, like someone canceled and then it booked it.
Okay,
so it's the first time we're using this, so I'd be curious.
So yeah, it showed up as agent third party, which is why it didn't show up as
that makes sense.
Name. Do keep in mind that checkout is at 1.
Okay.
Check-in's normally at 3. Fortunately, our camp hosts are Johnny on the spot, and somebody left early, so you get in this time.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate that.
Camper tag.
Okay, great.
Sounds good.
Enjoy your stay.
Well, thank you very much. Have a great day. Well, we just snuck right in on that one. She said, basically, don't get used to this. This is going to be a one-time thing. The Hanks understand these consequences that we get ourselves into. We told her, nonetheless, it's totally well-received on our end.
Well,
I mean, if they would have said no, we would have been totally okay with that.
Well, yeah, we understand that we're early and we would have just waited.
Yeah.
We wouldn't have went anywhere. There's nowhere, when you have a big rig like this,
right?
There's nowhere to go.
Yeah.
Except just kind of hang out and wait.
So I guess don't make a habit out of this, but it doesn't hurt to try. I don't know. Well, you know, we're in. That's all that matters right now. On to the next hurdle of backing in and getting set up. And then updating you guys a little bit about some things we've been wanting to discuss. You know, the Hanks way of doing things. Welcome to the craziness. Excited to see how this turns out. It looks really nice so far. I see campers over here. Hey, this is really nice.
Probably gonna be a favorite until we see the cell service.
Well, then I would have to say we got Starlink just in time. And the best part is, no trees above us. It's not gonna be official test run, but it's gonna be a good indication of kind of where we stand in these state parks. Whole open sky. And Starlink is gonna rip. It's gonna rip hard.
I think we're actually gonna hang out outside a lot.
Size of the site. It's so nice.
Maybe we shouldn't tell people about this. If you're watching, don't tell anybody else.
I think Starlink's going to do just fine here. Yeah, it's not an official test pilot for how well it does in trees, but nonetheless, at least you know some state parks are accommodating to the Starlink, and they have some open skies, which will be nice. So I'll keep you posted on the speeds. We don't really have data here with the cell phones. We utilize AT&T, and we have hotspots as well, but it's kind of nice to have some options when you're out on the road. What are you doing? Oh my goodness.
Just organizing. With RV life, you organize every
week.
Can I ask you, how are the Starlink speeds?
I guess I'll show you.
Don't outdo yourself.
I'm still getting used to, like, using this app.
Wow, that's really good. 116?
We have this app called Coverage, and I think it's $10 one-time purchase. Look at all the places that don't really have cell phone coverage, let me show you. If you're RVing, there's so many places. Everything in green you're seeing is, like, places that don't really have good cell coverage, especially when you get out west. So if you're looking to really explore out west, I would say, like, go for it with the Starlink. And the only spot in Florida that doesn't really have good cell coverage is where we are. I mean, we have some of it's pretty good.
I think it's nice having the flexibility of going between the cell phones, like Nate was saying. If we get to a spot, we don't have to stress if we don't have cell phone service. We just throw up the Starlink and we're good to go. Yes, we are paying for both services, so you got to take that into account. If you feel like you can't afford both of them out on the road, you're just getting started in the RV life, then do what you think is going to be most useful to you. I would encourage sticking with the cell phone plan and going from there. Starlink might be my last option, because with the cell phone plan, at least you have flexibility to actually use it, text, stuff like that. Do what you will with that. We just want to bring you a little snippet of what the Hanks are rolling with on the road. Are you guys still in there? Are you with us? First off, I want to say a couple big things about state parks. Why do we love them so much? Well, a big reason is it gets you out in nature a little bit more. It's a lot more quiet than normal RV resorts. It's peaceful out here, guys. The Florida state parks really go above and beyond in making sure your stay is comfortable. I mean, you got pristine sights. It is wide open. You're not on top of your next door neighbor. I mean, it is just a breath of fresh air, literally. Tonight we have hookups even. We got 50 amp, obviously the option for 30 amp if you need it. We got water, but we do not have sewer. So what do we do to help conserve on some of this tank space, as you will? Well, we don't sweat the small stuff. Boy, let me tell you how nice it is to take a really long hot shower. Not that we don't enjoy our home on wheels and what the shower provides on the road, but when you get to places like this, it is just a new flavor of life, if you know what I mean. You give up the sticks and bricks, and it's nice to get a little taste of that back out on the road. These state park campgrounds stay up on their actual bathroom facilities so well. I mean, a lot of these places are really nice, and we utilize their facilities as if they were our own. We are here in the peak season of Florida, and you guys may be asking yourself, how did the Hanks family land Colt Creek State Park? Well, if you have been following us for any time at all, or if you're new here, the Hanks do a little thing called Hanksing it. I just made that up, actually. Basically, we just fly by the seat of our pants. I get it. You may or may not be comfortable with the lifestyle that we live. Yes, we have been winging it ever since we've been down here in Florida. That's right. We have not made a single reservation since being here. I guess it's more of my way of saying don't stress so much about life, and it's okay to not have a plan. Maybe this is just our way of saying that if some reason you're not able to make every single plan work out according to the way you want it to, hey, it's okay. Take a breath. Everything's gonna be all right. Does it require a little bit more flexibility at times? Of course it does, but we have never been turned away. We're utilizing a program that we just found. Now, I don't wanna go sharing this program just quite yet, and the reason I say that is because I wanna make sure this is actually up to our standards before we tell y'all about it. I don't wanna go getting everyone's hopes up and this being a major flop. Our intention is always to bring you the best content and all the best knowledge of how to be successful on the road, and I'm gonna do just that. So let me give this a few more trial runs before actually telling you guys exactly what this is. You guys go pay money for something that you just never use. You guys know how it is. You're always presented with all this information out here, all these dealers and other people saying you have to have this and that and this and that. Take it from the Hanks, guys. We don't ever keep up with the trends. We are always last of the food bowl. This is our little way of showing you that you could trust us, and we're gonna bring you the best information. I'll get that program to you guys later on if I think it's up to our standards. So far though, we're looking pretty good. I remember when we first started full timing, Nay and I always had these expectations that we speak of. Where are we gonna go? What are we gonna do? Where are we gonna stay? Last night we were in Camp Margaritaville, and we still did not have that answer. Until this morning, we finally got a text message saying that the campground reservation came through for us. We had had some feelers out there at different local state park campgrounds, and this one actually had a reservation open up for us last minute. This happens all the time. In Florida, there are so many people that make reservations way in advance, and then things just happen.
and those people actually have to cancel their reservations, and lo and behold, insert the Hanks family to snatch them up at the last minute. Yes, we have been able to land some amazing places in peak season. We're heading out in a few days. We're gonna head north and meet up for our caravan. It's gonna be quite the journey, ladies and gentlemen. You know how it goes with the Hanks. We don't hold back on anything. Sometimes a peek behind the curtain can be quite interesting, and that's the way I love to look at other people's lives. What's really going on behind the scenes? I'm hoping you're feeling those vibes from the Hanks family. Don't sweat the small stuff. Take it at your own pace and enjoy this way of life. You only got one life to live, so live it up.